Times and recorded record-breaking sales worldwide.
An anniversary tour to celebrate 25 years since one of their most successful albums hit the charts will now go ahead in the autumn. It was delayed several times over the course of last year or so. Let's take a listen to some of those greatest hits.
I wish our next guest and everybody could see Dan singing along to that. It's been fantastic.
I very much enjoyed that. That's like a large slice of me growing up there. Lead singer of Suede, Brett Anderson, delighted to say, joined us on the programme. Good morning to you. Thank you very much for being with us this morning. Louise is enjoying me singing along, but I wonder whether how you feel about that this morning. Does it make you feel full of joy that it's 25 years? You're slightly depressed that it's quarter of a century.
Does it make me feel of joy that you were singing along?
No, not the singing along, no.
it's a nice trip down memory lane, I suppose. Yeah, it's nice. It's nice kind of, it's almost like having a kind of, you know, a really interesting photo album or something, you know, of your life, but kind of a musical photo album, I suppose. It's kind of quite a nice little snapshot into the past, yeah.
Well, give us an idea then of how you, say you're going through that sort of photo album. How does it make you feel? Do you look back fondly at that time?
Yeah, I do. I mean, it was an exciting time. You know, one's 20s are always really exciting. They kind of define you, don't they? And being in a band in your 20s is kind of one of the most exciting things that you can do. And I look back very fondly. It's nice to have, like I said, it's kind of nice to have these things because I don't really personally remember that much of it, you know. So it's nice to have photos and documentaries and videos and stuff like that. Otherwise, I wouldn't remember kind of hardly any of it. So.
It's interesting as well because looking back, you sort of, I suppose, part of a movement that when you're part of it, you probably don't realise the sort of Brit pop movement. Did it feel like that at the time? Did it feel like you were doing something different?
Well, history has a habit of kind of oversimplifying things. When Suede first started, it didn't feel like we were part of a movement at all. When we were writing songs about British life in, you know, 1992, 1991, it felt very much against the grain. Mm. It felt like we were doing something that no one else was doing. And we were kind of documenting British life rather than celebrating it. And I think later in the decade, other bands were celebrating British life. It was a very different attitude we had to it.
Yeah.
And I think we opened the doors to that movement, but I never particularly felt much kinship with it, to be honest. I've always felt that Suede were kind of just separate from everyone.
You started it. In some ways, you sort of you've come forward, but you're going backwards because you're going to go on tour, but you're touring your 1996 album coming up. So why particularly that one?
Well, it's the 25th anniversary, and as a band, I don't think we could look back unless we look forward. So we're currently making a new album. We've been making new records for the last sort of 7 or 8 years. And that's where the creative impetus lies. But that kind of allows us to look back on what we've done in the past. And sometimes it's quite helpful for your creativity looking back at what you've done in the past. It can kind of inform what you do now. And so I don't mind doing these retro things in lots of ways. I couldn't do them if that was the only thing we were doing. That would be a kind of a kind of a living death for me. I wouldn't just be happy doing the greatest hit circuit and doing the retro thing if we weren't making new music. And so it's that kind of duality that kind of enables us to look back, I think. Yeah.
And the whole sort of playing an entire album, I suppose, is it in the track order that it was originally came out in as well?
Probably. I haven't quite decided yet, but coming up was actually a very good album to play live, and a good record isn't always a good live record. And we've made records, we've done album shows before. Our second album, Dog Man Star, is probably our most sort of kind of critically acclaimed record, and that's not a great record to play live. There's lots of slow moments that don't quite translate live as a whole album. But coming up is a very sort of fizzy, brash pop record. It's a kind of like a kind of a gnarly, spiky little kind of pop album. And it kind of really works like.
I love all those descriptions. Would you describe the new album like that? Fizzy, gnarly, spiky. What is it?
The new album is nasty, brutish, and short.
Right. Have you enjoyed writing it?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I love writing new music. It's kind of what we do. It kind of gets harder as you get older, to be honest. The creative juices are harder to sort of squeeze out. But when you get them, when you get that gold dust, it's amazing.
I love speaking to artists and those with a creative brain like yourself about the last 12 months. Do you think that has forced you to come up with new stuff? Has it helped you? Has it sort of dried up those juices? How does it feel?
I think you were kind of, everyone was forced just to sort of to readjust and to sort of recalibrate what they do. We just spent the time writing a new record, and we were kind of in the middle of rehearsing it when lockdown happened. But looking back on it, it was actually quite useful because we went away and wrote a couple of songs that were really key to the record, and so that was quite good. I think everyone kind of had this idea that they were going to go away and learn Japanese or something, and that kind of quickly dissolved into. So yeah, it was productive at first, and then it got less productive.
Did you try Japanese?
No, I'm not great with languages. No, I'm better with songs.
Oh, well, thank you so much for coming on and telling us a bit about it.
Thank you so much for having me.
You take care. Thank you very much indeed. There's a documentary about Suede's album coming up. It's on Sky Arts Friday at 9 p.m. And then, as he said, they're on tour from September.
I think I know what music I'm listening to today.
Are you in?
I'm there. That's brought me right back.
That is all from us this morning. Thank you for watching.